Hello again, how are you? Welcome to our YouTube channel Engineers World. Hope you all might be busy in continuing your preparations for various examinations. So we were studying the subject of reinforced cement concrete, and in this subject we started working stress method, and I already explained you about the various assumptions that are used in working stress method. Now we will be doing some analysis by using working stress method. So today our topic is analysis of a singly reinforced section by using working stress method. Singly reinforced section, I will be writing it as SRS, by using working stress method, WSM. So now we are analyzing this singly reinforced section for any bending moment, let it be BM. So we will be using a lot of formulas. First of all, we must see here, if this is a section of a singly reinforced rectangular beam in which this is our neutral axis, this is our tension steel, it can be called as AST, area of steel in tension. This is our actual depth of neutral axis, XA. Now, if I draw the stress diagram comes out to be like this. And stress developed in concrete at top will be called as CA. Let it be represented by CA. And stress developed in steel will be represented as TA. So stress in steel. It will be written as TA, or can be represented by TA. Now, if this is our CG, this is our neutral axis. Now, we know that the resultant compressive force, let it be called as C force. Resultant compressive force acts at a distance of XA by 3 from topmost compression fiber. That is XA by 3, where XA, I already told you, is the actual depth of neutral axis. So this is our C force. And here our tensile force is acting. And by using modular ratio, this can be written as TA by M. Now, this gap between the C force and T force is called as lever arm. So, this is called as lever arm. And here, if this is the overall depth, capital D, and this will be our effective depth up to the center of steel, small d. So, our lever arm can be simply effective depth minus XA by 3. So this is our lever arm. Now coming to the various forces. Now coming to various forces, that is total compressive force, total tension force, and other important formulas. For that, I may write them here. If I talk about total compressive force, see, from the stress diagram, the total compressive force is represented by C. See, it can be written as B. What is B? B is the width of section. B into XA into CA by 2. So this will be the formula for total compressive force, that is C force. And the formula for total tensile force T will be equal to simply TA into AST. Because we know that force is equal to stress into area. So, total tension force or tensile force will be simply stress TA that is existing in steel into area of steel AST. And similarly, total compressive force is this B into XA into CA by 2. That is half of this width into this portion that is XA into the stress in concrete. So this was all about total compressive force and total tensile force. And lever arm, I already told you that is the distance between the C force and T force. And always remember, C force is always equal to T force. This must be always remembered. Now we will be moving on to some general formulae that are very important to be remembered for analyzing a singly reinforced beam, rectangular beam. So there are some general formulae. First one is formula for calculation of actual neutral axis. So for calculation of actual neutral axis, we have the formula as B into XA square by 2 is equal to M, where M stands for modular ratio, into AST into D is effective depth minus XA. XA is again depth of actual neutral axis. So this formula must be remembered as this is used for the calculation of actual neutral axis. So this is formula one, number one. Now, as I already told you that always C force is equal to T force. We know the formula of C and we know the expression of T. So by equating both, we can derive a new formula. That is, we know that C force was equal to B into XA into CA by 2. And our T force was simply TA into AST. So our next important formula becomes this. B into XA into CA by 2 into is equal to TA into AST. Now, moving on to the next type of formulas. And next is for calculation of any bending moment. So we have two formulas. Bending moment is equal to C force into lever arm. I am representing lever arm as LA. We know the formula both. C force is B into XA into CA by 2. And our lever arm is D minus XA by 3. So this is the formula of bending moment by using expression of C force. Similarly, by using the expression of T force, bending moment comes out to be T into lever arm. Where T force is TA into AST. Into lever arm is again D minus XA by 3. So these were some of the important formulae which we need to remember for the analysis of a singly reinforced beam using working stress method. So first one was the formula of calculation of actual neutral axis, which is B into XA square by 2 equal to M into AST into D minus XA, where all the symbols have their usual meanings. And secondly, we are equating C force and T force, and we have resulted into a formula that is B into XA into CA by 2 is equal to TA into AST. And if we want to calculate the bending moment, we can use either C formula or T formula. So we get two expressions as shown in video. So now we also have one more formula, that is stress relation. So our fourth is stress relation. So what is that? If you write CA, that is stress in concrete at the top, upon XA, depth of actual neutral axis. We can write it as TA by M upon D minus XA. We are doing nothing but we are just taking the ratios of the stress diagram. See, this was stress diagram, or this value was TA by M, this value was CA, and this was our C force, which was acting at a distance of XA by 3, and this was our lever arm, that is D minus XA by 3. So we have just taken the ratios of sides, that is CA by XA, this is our XA. So CA by XA will be equal to TA by M upon D minus XA. This thing can be called as D minus, this depth is D minus XA, because this is our total effective depth. So by simply taking the ratios of the stress triangle, we have come to this expression. And this can be further written as equal to FCT upon total overall depth upon XA. So this is also one of the important formulas. So this is the stress relation. Now we will be solving a numerical based on these values. So we will solve a problem in which we are given the width of a beam, and we are also given AST, we are given the grade of concrete and grade of steel, and we have to find out the moment of resistance. So what will be we do? See, now we are going to solve a numerical problem on this. So the question says, calculate moment of resistance, I am writing it as MOR, of a singly reinforced beam, having the dimensions B is equal to 500 mm, that is width, overall depth is 1000 mm, effective cover he has given as 70 mm, AST he has given as 3 bars of 25 mm phi, that is dia. His writing is use working stress method, and the concrete used is M35 and steel is Fe415. So for solving this type of problem, first of all, we need to calculate the K values. We have to check, in the question he has not written as moment of resistance of a singly reinforced beam. He has simply asked us calculate the moment of resistance. So we have to first of all check whether it is a under reinforced, over reinforced or balanced section. For that, we need to calculate critical depth of neutral axis. Now, as per code, the formula for critical depth of neutral axis is XC is equal to K into D, where D is effective depth, and the value of K is different for different grades of steel. So, our IS code has given a table in which here we have different grades of steel. Here is the value of sigma ST, the value of K, and the value of XC. So we usually use three types of grades of steel. First is Fe250, another is Fe415, and last one is Fe500. So for Fe250, sigma ST is directly given as 140, K value is 0.40, and XC is simply K into D, that is 0.40D. Similarly, for Fe415, sigma ST is 230, K is 0.289 and our XC will be 0.289 D. For Fe 500, sigma ST is 275 Newton per mm square ampere and K value is 0.253 and our XC comes to be 0.253 D. So by making the use of this table, we can directly calculate the value of critical depth on neutral axis. So here our grade is Fe415, so we will use this formula 0.289 D. So our critical depth of neutral axis will be 0.289 D. So solving this, we will get 0.289 into D, but we have to first calculate D. He has given overall depth as 1000 mm and he has given us effective cover, let it be D dash, is equal to 70 mm. So our effective depth can be D is equal to overall depth minus D dash. That will be our 1000 minus 70. That will be equal to 930 mm. So this is our effective depth. So from this we can calculate critical depth of neutral axis as 0.289. into 930, so that comes out to be 268.77 mm. So this is our critical depth of neutral axis. Now we have to calculate actual depth of neutral axis, so we will use the first general formula. So what was that? The formula was, I'll write it here, our formula was B, this is for XA. Formula was B into X square by 2 is equal to M into AST into D minus XA. We know all the values except XA. So we will put these values and get the same. Now coming to modular ratio. We know that the formula for modular ratio is M is equal to 280 by 3 sigma CBC. So in for M35 grade, we know that the sigma CBC value is 11.5. That is directly given in a table in IS456. So by putting these values, we will get the value of modular ratio as 8.12. Now we'll put all these values and we'll see. So on putting these values, the value of B is 500. XA we have to calculate, M is our 8.12, AST is 3 bars of 25 mm, that is 3 into pi by 4 into 25 square into 930 minus XA. So upon solving, we will finally get the value of actual depth of neutral axis as 188.35 mm. Here we see that the actual depth of neutral axis is less than critical depth of neutral axis. So our section will be under a reinforced section. XA is less than XC. So under reinforced section. Now we will solve accordingly. Or XA will be less than XC. So if I again draw the section will be like, this is our steel. If this was our this is our critical depth of XC, that is critical depth of neutral axis, and our actual depth of neutral axis has come to be less. So this is our XA. So if we draw the stress diagram, it will be like this. this is our TA by M. Our width was 500 mm, that is B. And overall depth is 1000 mm, that is overall depth. Our actual fish should diagram should be like this, but as this came out to be under reinforced section, so our stress diagram came out to be like this. Here it is our sigma CBC. This is our C force. So this will be our lever arm, and we know the value of lever arm as D minus X A by 3, that is actual depth of needle. So that's why we took C value from here. Now we know that total tension force is TA into AST or sigma ST into AST. Now this is now the stress distribution for this under reinforced section. Now we'll calculate the moment of resistance. So for under reinforced section, our CA will be less than sigma CBC, as I already explained you in some video in which I explained the differences between the under reinforced, over reinforced and balanced section. So, and TA will be equal to sigma ST, which will be equal to 230 Newton per mm square. That is from the table which I have drawn in earlier. So the formula for moment of resistance MOR will be TA into AST into small d minus XA by 3. TA will be equal to sigma ST. AST will be same d minus XA by 3. Now we know the value of sigma ST. Our sigma ST here is 230 from table, and AST we calculated it to be 3 bars of 25 mm die, which came to be 1472.62 mm square. Effective depth is 930 mm. 35 divided by 3. And if I want to convert it into kilonewton meter, I'll divide it by 10 to the power 6. So our moment of resistance finally comes out to be 293.73 kilonewton meter. So this is our moment of resistance. So this was all about the analysis of this singly reinforced section. We can also use a different approach. Like if we use the stress relation, we can also calculate the moment of resistance. So also I'll also show how to calculate by using stress relation. If we use stress relation from compression side, which will be CA by XA is equal to sigma ST by M upon D minus XA. We know all the values. So, but we don't know what's the value of CA. So we will calculate CA from here. So our CA will be sigma ST by M. Sigma ST is our 230. M is our 8.12. Into XA, actual depth of neutral X is 188.35 upon D minus XA. D is our 930 minus 188.35. So this value comes out to be 7.193 Newton per mm square. Now we know the formula for MR, that is the moment of resistance. It is B into XA into CA by 2, I am using the compression side formula, into D minus XA by 3. So we'll put all the values. We know B is 500 mm into X is 188.35 into C is 7.193 by 2, and our effective depth was 930 minus 188.35 by 3. And to convert it into kilonewton meter, I'll divide it by 10 raised to 6. So on solving this, we get the same value as 293.73 kilonewton meter. So this was all about today's lecture, in which we solved a numerical based on analysis of singly reinforced beam using working stress method, in which we analyzed it by calculating the moment of resistance. So that was all for today. Hope you would have liked the lecture.